The second episode featured Sean, a small-town fellow from Wisconsin, but don't let that baby face of his fool you. His nice guy charm is a proven strategy for getting girls. We paired him up with the equally cute actress, Meredith. Will Sean keep smiling in the face of adversity, or will the game killers rise to the challenge? It all started at world-famous Coney Island. Sean and Meredith have the cutest date in history. They eat hot dogs, frolic on the beach, ride the roller coaster, and hit the bumper cars, where Sean finds himself face to face with 200 pounds of pure muscle, bent on his destruction.
Oh no. Someone's about to muscle in on Sean's fun. Meet Early Man. 240 pounds of meat, 1 ounce of brains.
What's your freaking problem? What are you looking at? You want some of this?
This knuckle-dragging alpha male can be found frequenting squat racks, nutrition centers, and the area right in front of your face. Sink down to Early Man's devolved state of existence, and he will kill your game.
These steroids are delicious.
And then he will kill you.
Who bumped into you? What happened?
The lady.
What lady?
The lady over there.
What, are you stupid or what?
There's no need to insult
are you
me,
okay?
sir.
No need to insult you. You're bringing this to my son.
Sorry, I think
hey,
I don't think he meant that.
This is bumper cars, man.
Bumper cars my ass. I'll bumper car the side of your
fucking
head.
Are you okay?
Oh, hey, there's no need for that, man.
You know, I get 2 days a month with this kid.
Sir,
and you gotta go fucking ruin one of them? Who's this fucking guy? Farrah Fawcett over here?
What Sean didn't know is that this was just the start of it. Sex in the City won't be happening for Sean unless he gets past the Swarm. Four of Meredith's best friends who want to know everything about him. Everything.
Meet the Swarm. This eight-legged, four-headed monster will obliterate your game.
You're not good enough.
We're your worst nightmare.
Their volume alone is enough to make your manberries retreat into your upper torso.
Do you ever cheat?
What's up with your hair?
What's your favorite position?
Have you ever been with a prostitute?
Have you had any gay encounters?
Meredith's last boyfriend was huge.
I dare you to take off your shirt and show Meredith.
Take it off! Take it off! Take it off! Take it off!
I can't watch this. You didn't even put up a fight.
And finally, how about an evening at the theater in New York City? That can be very romantic. Unless you're on a date with Meredith and the performance is Sensitivo, her BFF.
Meet Sensitivo. He's the barely male irritant who operates under the guise of your girl's best friend.
It's all the songs we danced to in high school.
I made you this friendship bracelet.
But he's always been secretly in love with her.
It's our 16-year friendship anniversary. Give me a kiss.
But if he can't have her, he'll turn things ugly, so no one can.
Call me later if you want to bitch about it.
Wow. It's like that. It's like that tank top I wanted.
I know.
You knitted it.
I did.
Who?
Wow, fabulous, man.
I did.
Oh my God.
Like, you know how to knit and stuff. That's wild.
It doesn't make me like less of a man. I can make my own clothes.
You are just a spectacular guy, man.
I'd say, he's just kidding, silly.
Oh, sure, I'd love to come see your show. And because I am not sensitive to your feelings ever, I've brought a date. And here he is. Oh, yeah, sure. Oh, boy, I sure would love to go see a show in New York City.
Sean has front row seats to Sensitivo's true feelings for her. But the spotlight is on him. The entire premise of the show is built around Axe's brand platform by asking guys if they had what it takes to win in the mating game. We were able to organically integrate the brand throughout the entire show by positioning the brand in the role of the older brother, giving guys tips, advice, and insight.
Most guys would have abandoned their date and run for the alleys, but Sean isn't most guys. He stands by his girl no matter what comes his way.
Our contestants were judged and scored throughout each episode. At the end of each date, an Axe-branded animated puppet theater recapped our guy's encounter with the game killer, giving a play-by-play of the date and ending with an assessment of his performance.
Sensitivo turned the spotlight from himself and turned the heat up on Sean.
It's okay. You're smoking.
Then a score for each date was calculated and totaled at the end of the show.
For good humorosity, you get a 5,000, taking you all the way to the famed Chalice Cup.
We also created Axe Tips for handling these game killers. We shared a different tip for each game killer encountered. It only makes sense that there would be a prize for the guy who fared best against the game killer. This one just so happened to be the holy grail of the mating game, the Axe Game Killer's Chalice. The game killer's concept has been a phenomenal success. It provides great entertainment for guys, there is a clear yet organic role for the brand, and Axe continues to place itself firmly on its throne as the king of the mating game, and hopefully help guys around the world to lock down more tails.